What is up, guys? It is Dwarfism here, and we are playing Elitescape this time. I'm going to do a server tour, show you guys around, show you a couple quick unique things that they have about this server, and yeah, it's going to be pretty exciting, boys. Let's get on. So the first thing I'm going to show you is the Last Man Standing minigame that they have. I'm going to go and jump into it, show you guys what they have to offer. It is it's similar to the one they have in RuneScape, but it's slightly different in its own unique way. I find it, there's a few things I would want it to be changed, but besides that, I think it's really fun to do. It only takes about 15 minutes for each round, for the game to finish, and there's 8 rounds. But I will show you guys that once I get into those clips. All right, so in Last Man Standing, as we have here, I sped up the clips. It is 8 rounds, 4 are 1v1s, and 4 are multi-combat, and alternates. So the first one's solo, the next one is multi, and so on. Now, it starts off with beginning free-to-play gear, so as you can see in here. I'm doing a 1v1. It gives you all the stuff, like, gives you mage, range, and melee stuff. I don't know how this didn't actually kill him. He was literally 2 hit points, and I rune-2-hand and missed. And then when you die, you respawn as a ghost, so other players can't see you, but you can see other ghosts and you can see other players. And then every round, it spawns you in. You only get a couple food. The food levels up, same with your gear. And so you can see this round is multi-combat. People are pooping on each other. I have 1 LMS points, and the opponents on the top left corner are 7 remaining. I just skipped around a little bit. And then it slowly spawns you in, so this is another multi. I'm spawning in with Berserker gear, kind of. They give you the Berserker, the Range, and the Mage. Kind of mediocre gear this time. You can use Prayer this time as well. And it ends in 1 minute, so people don't just run off and stuff. So, I don't know. The one thing I would recommend is maybe before each round, you can pick what you want to be. Or maybe even just give you more food. I don't know. It's a little annoying. You only have 4 food. I wish fights were a little bit longer. Because it's mainly based to RNG at that point, but it is really fun to play. Each round, I think, gives you more time to fight, depending on the gear you have, possibly. I could be mistaken on that, but as you can see, this is a 1v1. We both get Barrow's gear along with the AGS this time, and we have some prayers going on, DFS and such. And so, I don't know, I had a lot of fun doing this, got a lot of footage doing this as well. As you can see, the more people that die, I don't see any of these ghosts that are walking around. But as soon as I die, I can see all the other people that have already died, and I can see the rest of the fight. So the next one is multi with the DH and the Carls. Now, I'm going to leave the last, I think I skipped the last one or last two possibly, just because one, I had enough footage, and two, I want to leave you guys to actually check it out for yourselves and to see the gear that you guys get. It is pretty juicy. It's pretty nice, the gear that they let you spawn with and try out. So yeah. So the next thing I want to show you is the player-owned stores. This is basically a GE among the players. To look at your own player-owned store, you go to colon sell, and it pops up your own store of what I'm selling. Unfortunately, I'm not selling anything right now. If you want to see someone else's shop, you do :// shop and then the name. Okay, so we found a player who has a shop. I just did :// shop and then space their name, Ultros. Yeah, Ultros has stuff in his shop. You can see he's got wooden shields in here. He's got Seer's rings. We got Robin Hood hats and just a couple other things in here. A little bit more cosmetics and some bolts and stuff. But it's really easy to use the player-owned stores. You just find someone's name, you go and look at it. Or if you're talking in the clan chat and you're like, okay, I'm selling these items, boys. Check out my shop. You don't have to leave what you're doing. You don't have to leave your Slayer task or whatever. You can just do and type in their name while you're doing something else and see what they have to offer. I can show you guys another shop if that makes it easier. Alright, so this is a big player, I can tell. Instacell. He has a lot of items in his store. So if you want to do, you can value the item so I can see what it's worth so you don't get scammed. 200 mil, or 200 mil, 55 mil for those Furies. A lot of these items are max cash stacks, but it looks like this one's, you know, 3.5 mil when it's valued at 2.1, but it's really easy to see what things are worth, what's worth buying. But I think it's really convenient for players to use that instead of having an actual store or a person to an NPC to click on and stuff, because it makes it much more easier to be doing other things and just do type in the person's name and find the stuff you want to look at. So the next thing I'm going to show you guys before I get into some bossing is the teleport interface. Now, you can use this stuff, but I would recommend using the teleportation options. It's basically the world map or the globe or whatever. Click on it, and it brings up your teleport interface. So the first thing on here is the training. It gives you all the stuff you can teleport into. Giant's Experiments, Bandit Camp, I believe. Oh, there is no rock crabs on here, or unless that's, I don't know, that's interesting. Anyways, the mini games, they have the bossing, Last Man Standing, Duel Arena, Castle Wars, and so on. In the bosses category, there is Boss Slang, and then a bunch of wieldy bosses in here, along with Chaos Elemental, which I think is also in the wieldy. Player Killing, Edge Varrock, Hellhounds, Mage Arena, and Green Dragons. And then skilling is all the basic stuff that you would need to teleport to, which is pretty nice. And then donor I can't go to, but which is obviously donor stuff. Now, I think there is a few things missing in this teleport interface, so you guys can go ahead and just check out these in here, which should have everything. Like rock crabs are in here, cyclopses are in here, tormented demons are in here. So any extra stuff that it's not in the in this teleport interface, I'm sure is in this stuff. So from that, let's move into some bossing. So teleport to bossing, just do :: bossing, or you can go to the teleporting stuff and just click on the boss teleport. Now, I think this is really interesting because you can have your clan members in here, obviously, but if I go ahead and talk to, where is he, this scrub lord in the red, I can go to rewards, and instead of getting drops when killing the bosses, although you might be able to, you also get boss points, and you can exchange those points for the items that you'll be killing, or for the items that you would have gotten when killing the bosses. So I think that's really interesting and really fun, a new way to kind of get loot. I just missed out on the drop, I think, Rip and Pepperonis. But you have your bank right here, and you can join with a public lobby, or you can go privately with your clan, and then you can check your boss logs and stuff. So it's pretty awesome. I think I'm going to go and get started on this, and I'll see you guys in just a moment. Okay, when you first spawn in, you actually get to pick which bosses you want to fight, and your team gets to pick. I think it's really fun that it tells you the hit points each monster has at the top. So Skeletor has health 900 or 516 at that point out of 900. It tells you how many kills you have and how many, the time limit you've got, and so on. So the first one we did was the skeleton guy. We had a bunch of people in here. We get to vote for the next one. I think we did the Calfight Queen, yeah, we teleported to Calfight Queen, even though I voted for the Bandos guy, and we had probably about 10 players here, which is really fun. We just kept going and going and going. I think we did about 4 rounds or so, and then I realized I had enough footage, and so I jumped out. It was really interesting to see how unique this kind of mini game, not even a mini game, it feels like a mini game though, because it's just a lot of people killing the things, getting loot, getting points together, and I don't know, it made a lot of fun. Next thing we did was the Nomad boss, and he has 1,300 hit points, and we were just kind of destroying this thing with that Ranger getting destroyed as well. We had 9 games, lobby of 3, and with the voting ending in a couple seconds, we did Corporal Beast spawning in the same room. This thing, 1,500 hit points, I think it's normally spawns with 2k, but has 500 in this point. And I don't know, it's really interesting. It's really unique. It feels like a mini game. It's not very difficult. I think it gives a big advantage to Iron Man because, as you can see, Cobb said 10% and he can get his points, and he doesn't have to solo these bosses. He can just do it with some buddies, and as long as he gets that 10%, he gets those points. So I don't know, it makes it really fun and really convenient. So you can go to your boss logs now, and I have 1 kill for all of these things, and I can go to my points. I don't know if it tells me how many points I have when I click on it. I don't have enough, obviously, but if I try to buy something, you don't have enough points. So I don't know, it makes it really cool, and I'm going to get out of here, boys, before I get teleported to the next area. And the final thing I'm going to show you guys before I finish the video is the mini me. So the mini me is right here, mini dwarf level 19, level 28. Now you have to have 99 summoning in order to summon one. And when you do have 99 summoning, you go to your summoning, click on the call follower, and it will teleport in, or spawn in, I should say. Then you can go to :: train, or just train however you would like. And you can go to your claw, and it will change the attack styles or just attack certain things. So I can go combat stats, check out the stats. 43 attack, 21 defense, one defense, 21 strength, and the rest are all ones. You can even train up your prayer, which is pretty awesome. And yeah, so mine's right now just going off attacking different things. Let's go and change its attack style to defense. And I can give it equipment in order to level up. So it used to be 28, now it's actually 30. And yeah, it's pretty juicy. I don't know why he's running back and forth like a freaking idiot, but he is doing his training. And I can actually do training with him once I can attack the thing if I want. I would want him to get the most amount of experience. And then if I eventually get him high enough level, give him some good gear. I can go Slayer, I could do bossing and stuff like that. I can, yeah, check his stats. I've already done that. You can train up his prayer. But yeah, I think that's everything, boys. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I will see you guys next time. I hope you guys can get 99 summoning and try this out because it's pretty sweet. Level 32 already. And now I guess I will see you guys next time. Hope you guys did enjoy, like always. And peace, boys.